Before drilling any pilot holes, we want to select a drill bit that is about the same diameter as the shank of the screw. If you place the shank of the drill bit on top of the shank of the screw, you should still be able to see the threads of the screw. This is the size diameter drill bit that we need to be using for pilot holes. We also need to take a look at the hinge itself. If we look at the back side, we can see where there are cut marks that the hinge pin fits around. These cut marks I'm going to use as a reference line when installing the hinge on the blanket chest. I'm first going to position it in place and then take a really close look at where those cut marks or reference line is in relation to the back surface of my blanket chest. The reference line needs to be directly in line and flush with that back blanket chest surface. This means that the hinge pin will actually sit a little bit behind or off of your project. Once we've positioned our hinge exactly where we need it to be, using that reference line and making it flush with the back of our project, we want to drill 3 pilot holes, one on each end and one in the center. Once our 3 pilot holes are drilled, we are going to use 3 screws and a screwdriver with a nice, good tip. We do not want to use a drill to screw these in because it'll strip out the heads of the screws. And we only want to screw them until they're snug. At this point, we have 3 screws installed in our hinge, one on each side and one in the middle. If something moved on you or something got off a little bit, what you need to do is remove one of the installed screws, reposition the hinge, drill a new pilot hole in a different location right next to it, and then install a new screw. Once you have the hinge positioned correctly and those 3 screws installed, don't install any more screws just yet.